Welcome. We're in the middle of a refurbishment, a transformation, if you will, the second largest in the history of the NBA. We're rebuilding this arena from the roofline to the baseline, and every element will be new. This is the first club that we're opening, and it's the first of six that will be opened in the fall of 2018. But we wanted to give you a sample, and we wanted to give you a taste. You can't have a great night out without a great meal. Take a look at me, I know what I'm talking about. I'm an expert in the art of cuisine. And we wanted to do something that really hadn't been done in Atlanta. We wanted to bring fine dining and entertainment together. So we said to ourselves, what's the best chef? What's the best restaurant in this city? And we went and saw the movie Baby Driver. And Baby Driver had a scene between Baby and his girlfriend. And he wanted to woo her, and he said, I'm going to take you to the best restaurant in Atlanta, honey. I'm going to take you to Bacchanalia. And we said, you know what? That's where we're going to go. And at Bacchanalia, we found the incredible Joe Schaefer. Woo! And he's become a great friend, a fabulous partner, and the visionary behind the food scene at Phillips Arena. So I hope you have a wonderful time tonight. Thank you for your participation. It's not exactly the most beautiful night to be out. And without any further ado, Chef Joe Schaefer.
How are you doing, guys?
Hi.
Thank you for being here tonight. It's a big honor for me to be a part of this, what's going on here at the arena with the Hawks and the big renovations and everything that we have kind of in store for the rest of the season and going into next season. Real quick, I do want to just talk about how I came to be here, like, along with Steve. What he said was, you know, spot on for real. But I had a long, long, really awesome career in fine dining and nice restaurants and whatnot. And it came to a point where I was thinking, what are we going to do next with this? I was thinking more 3 to 5 years, right? But it ended up being like more 3 to 5 weeks where this sort of like came my way, and it was an exciting opportunity. I really wanted to jump on it. I go to a lot of restaurants and cook and have a good time and, you know, do my thing, right? But I wanted to learn something different in the process. So it's been a long career so far. Let's shake it up a little bit, take a right turn, see where we can go with this thing. And bringing my experience to the arena and techniques and some of my former employees and just people that I know in the community that like to cook and want to do it a different way, we're able to kind of put this something together. I think it's going to be really, really special. So with all that, Courtside Club itself, this menu changes all the time. This is kind of like the epicenter of what we have going on right now in the arena. And as you can see, we're doing some really, pretty cool stuff. We started out a little bit conservative, I think, at the beginning of the season. Then we've just been kind of pushing it, seeing what we can kind of get away with, what people are enjoying, and what, you know, makes them want to come back. And I think the biggest thing really is variety. And, you know, we're not churning out the same stuff all the time. Really, the only thing that is somewhat static in this room is going to be over here on the pizza side. We have a pizza oven, so we're going to use it all the time, right? And now we're doing a couple different pies, some nice stromboli, and we'll probably get some garlic knots out there eventually and do that kind of stuff. But everything in here is meant to be really creative, chef-driven, and just something different, something you wouldn't expect. You walk in the door, you're like, oh, wow, I didn't really expect to see guinea hen on the menu here at a place like this, but you're gonna, right? And this is not just this year we're doing this to hook them, and then we're gonna change it back to hot dogs next week. We're not doing that either, so. But this is a big part of it, but this is only a part of it, right? We're doing all the stuff. Concessions, suites, catering, everything that we do in the building, culinarily speaking, is under my purview, and I have an incredible staff of chefs that work for me right now that have a lot of creative juices that they want to get out there and get flowing, and even on the concession side, what we're going to do on that side, and how we're going to kind of bring that whole thing together and make it be more like neighborhood restaurants instead of a line of stands and more less monotonous and things of that nature. But so everything, in my opinion, is important. The hot dog or the pheasant, you know, the nachos or the ribeye, it's all the same thing to me. So it's about a philosophy that we're going to bring to the table of that chef quality restaurant sort of situation. It's been a big challenge, but honestly, it's been really fun. So I'm going to leave you guys with that before I ramble, because I do that. I just want everybody to kind of kick back, enjoy yourselves tonight. Ask any questions you have amongst the staff about the food, or what we're doing in here, or how this whole thing works, or what we have going in the future, feel free to ask, and I'm sure we can answer you. Thank you. Woo!